So that you talked about taking things down at request. I think that opens discussion for if something is added to the game that is, or, you know, somebody makes some user content that is, you know, problematic, but maybe gets some amount of following. I mean, you know, say somebody makes something that is wildly offensive, or you just have hundreds of penis characters, or just whatever.
Right.
You
sure.
know, how do you expect to deal with that same sort of thing? Just case by case, take them down as they show up?
Yeah, it's just going to have to be a case by case basis. We haven't talked too much about the penis characters.
That's hard to believe. Wildly, frankly,
I can think of like more wildly offensive things. We'd probably have to do something if we got like a bunch of penis assists. We'd have to stop them from like showing up. Like if I want to say, oh, I'm going to play a random, you know, user generated content today, I don't want it to be like that.
Yeah, we'll have to moderate to some degree,
right?
Yeah. The content, just to make sure.
As far as like, you know, racial slurs, caricatures, like anything super offensive like that, we would just remove it on a case by case basis. Like, I don't think we'd want that on our servers anywhere where people could access it through our game.
Yeah. Right. What about like nudity type? What if there's a not safe for work game, indie game that somebody wants to add and there's like a lewdness to it? Is there something that you have to do legally for that or something?
That's an interesting prospect. We'd probably have to gate it off some way. I don't think we've discussed about it that much.
Of course, it's me that thinks about like this kind of stuff.
Yeah, yeah, like Mugen already like exists with a similar issue, if you think about it.
Yeah, so. we might just have to like lock down on how you're able to share it. Like ultimately, if you send your friend a file and they open it in the game, they'll be able to do whatever they want. It's more about like having it available through our game that we'd be concerned about.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Interesting. Okay, I'm going to ask something that I feel like we're all going to think about in the next couple of weeks and months as the game comes out. You were letting people release millions of characters, hundreds of thousands, all with their own fighting styles, different moves. Balance?
Well, to some degree, that's going to have to be left up to the people making the characters. And if you look at other games with custom content in them, there are like clearly characters that are like, okay, I'm going to try really hard to make this in line with the base balance of the cast.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get the people who are less interested in that, who want to make like, I'm going to make a guy with a stick of dynamite that kills you right away. And if people want to do that, they can. Most of it, like, we're going to try to have some sort of curation tools that let you find like the more balanced characters. Hopefully the community will be able to sort some of that out themselves and like recommend and have like more downloads and whatever voting system we have.
Yeah, kind
with.
Of crowdsourcing the you know, that aspect.
But also like the most common or one of the most popular characters in I think every user-generated content game in existence is Ronald McDonald, who is intentionally overpowered. So I'm sure we'll end up with something like that and people are going to love playing it. My goal is that people are able to find what they're looking for. And if that's crazy characters or good characters or just like balanced characters, I think that's, I'm happy for them.
Okay. So when it comes to, it sounds like it's going to be the crowd managing themselves as far as making something overpowered, underpowered. Because I was wondering if there's some way to make metrics out of balancing a character. If like they punch for 5 points and that's more than the usual punch or 3 points, they have to take 2 points out of something else. Or if it's like that specific.
I've seen some people try to make systems, like if you could probably even find it online for how people try to classify Smash Brothers characters, for example. Mm-hmm. But I've never seen a system that can accurately rate how good a character is based on those metrics.
Yeah.
Usually it's just something that's going to be, at least for now, beyond the grasp of the machines to figure out.
Yeah.